Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. If you have not already subscribed to this channel, what are you doing? Please hit the subscribe button already. All right. In this video, you will learn how to create a stylish photo frame in PowerPoint. The beautiful, stylish photo frame you will learn to create today looks like this. Of course, you can replace this photo with any photo of your choice, and I will show you how easy it is to create this beautiful looking photo frame. As always, let us start from scratch. The first thing I'm going to do is to go to Auto Shapes Gallery. From Basic Shapes, I'm going to pick up this tool here called as Frame. I'm going to click on it and I'm going to hold the Shift button down as I draw a frame like this. You can always adjust the width of the frame by moving this adjustment handle. You can have it wider or you can have it narrower. It's completely up to you. Once you got this in place, I am going to go to Shape Outline and say No Outline. Right click, go to Format Shape. Then go to this option here called Size and Properties. Otherwise, you can always go to right click and go to Size and Position. It'll all take you to the same place. So go to Size and rotate it by 45 degrees. So it is here, rotation option, 45 degrees, and hit Enter, and you will have this kind of a shape. Once this is done, you can decide what size you want. If you are okay with a size that is as big as this, it's absolutely fine. If not, you can always hold the Shift button down and click and drag from the corner to readjust the height. All right, now we have got the frame in place. The next thing we need to do is to create the space for our photo. So let us go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the Rectangle tool from the Rectangles option. Hold the Shift button down as you draw a perfect square. Why hold the Shift button down? You might have already known this. Holding the Shift button down allows you to create shapes that have constrained proportions. So when you draw a rectangle while holding the Shift button, you will end up having a perfect square. Now I'm going to select the square here. Hold the Shift button down to select the frame. So both of them are selected, then go to Arrange, Align, and say Align Center, and then Arrange, Align, and say Align Middle. So this square is right in the middle of the frame, which is rotated by 45 degrees. Excellent so far. Let us go to this one, as always, Shape Outline, and say No Outline. And then I'm going to select both these shapes, that is the square and the frame, and I'm going to go to Format tab of PowerPoint ribbon, go to Merge Shapes, and I'm going to use the option called Fragment. So I'm going to click on Fragment option. Now everything is broken down into individual fragments. Now I'm going to fill certain shapes with orange color, and they are going to be replaced with a photo later on. So let us select the parts that need to be in orange color. So I'm going to select this. Give it orange color, this one orange color, this one orange color, this one. Can you see here? I am making the square go underneath the frame, so I am going to go for orange color here. The same way, this one orange color, and can you see this is almost like it is inserted into the frame? The same way, this one is also orange color. Beautiful, isn't it? So it looks like this square is inserted into the frame. So that is the effect we are going for. Now, to make it easy for ourselves, I am going to select all these orange portions and I am going to merge them together. So let us go to Format, Merge Shapes, and say Shape Union. So it is Union Shapes. Beautiful. The next thing is, we are going to have all the remaining portions merged together as well, leaving aside these small pieces here in the corner. So I'm going to hold the Shift button down as I select the piece in blue, leaving aside this. So I'm going to select this, 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 yeah, all of them. And once again, I'm going to go to Format Shape, Format, Merge Shapes, and Shape Union. So this is another piece. Now let us select these corner pieces here. These ones, while holding the Shift button, you give them a gray color like so. And then for this, let us give it a bright color. So let us go to this kind of an orange color. Now that looks beautiful. Now we need to fill this square with a good photo. Here on this slide, I have a beautiful photo. What I did is I selected the original photo, went to format, went to crop option, go to aspect ratio, and then I chose square, which is 1:1 ratio. And that meant that this photo is now in square shape. This is essential. If your photo is either vertically oriented or horizontally oriented, and if you try to fill this square shape with that picture, then you will see that the photo either gets squished or it gets stretched. We don't really want that. So make sure that the photo that you are filling it with is also a perfect square. Now I am going to right click, cut. So what I've done here is by cutting, I have placed that photo in the short-term memory of the computer called clipboard. Now, when I select this, go to fill, go to picture or texture fill, and then insert picture from. And when I hit clipboard, this strange phenomenon happens. That is because sometimes when you select the various pieces together and combine, you might actually have the orientation changed. Now, how do we make sure that the photo here has a proper vertical orientation? It's fairly simple. You go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up any shape, pick up a simple rectangle like this and draw the shape. It doesn't really have to be a perfect square or any such thing. Go to Shape Outline and say No Outline. Then you select the piece that you have drawn in the middle, hold the Shift button down as you select the shape behind. Yes, I call this the shape even though it has a photo. Now we have got both of them selected and the order of selection is important. And then you go to the Format tab under Drawing Tools, go to Merge Shapes and say Shape Union. Now, when we select this, right click, go to Format Shape, go to Fill option, go to Picture or Texture Fill. You know that the picture that is inserted from the clipboard is perfectly vertical. So that is how you create a stylish photo frame in PowerPoint. Now, once you've got this in the vertical orientation, then no matter what picture that you insert, it'll always be in the vertical orientation. Now, talking about showcasing of photos, there is one tool that can really change the game for you if you are a business presenter. And the tool is Comprehensive All-in-One PowerPoint Bundle. This bundle is a collection of more than 4,020 premium PowerPoint templates that allow you to convert any boring text-based slide into clear and compelling visual slide in a matter of minutes. I'm going to show you some example templates taken from our comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle that showcases pictures. The first example is this. Can you see here? It's a beautiful showcasing of pictures. Of course, you can replace this with any other picture of your choice. It is, after all, a shape that is filled with picture. Another one is this. Can you see? It all looks so beautiful and professional. And another example is this. There are three photos that are being showcased with this kind of light effect. Another example is this, where we showcase multiple small photos. You can always replace these with product pack shots, or if you have any certificate, you can use them. There is a whole bunch of ways in which you can use our picture-based templates. If you want animated versions, we have some very interesting options as well. Some of them are showcased here. The first one is about showcasing a picture with highlight like this. Another one is this, which has three images and text variation. On a click, I bring in the first photo, then I bring in the second one and the third one. And these can be easily replaced by you. You just need to replace this picture with any other picture using shape fill picture option. Another one is this, where we showcase five different photos around the central text. You can, of course, replace this text and you can replace these photos, and they showcase the idea beautifully, and you can see that the animation is really awesome. All these beautiful picture-based templates complete with animation are available readily in comprehensive all-in-one PowerPoint bundle. You just need to pick up the template, insert them into your presentation, replace the sample text and sample photo, and your slide gets ready in no time. It is arguably the smartest way to create great-looking presentations fast. I will leave a link to this useful product in the description box below the video. You can always click on the link and explore more about this useful product. If you want to receive useful PowerPoint tips and tricks that I share only with my email subscribers, please click on the link here and join our newsletter called Success by PowerPoint. The tips and tricks that I share with you are absolutely easy for you to follow, and you can use them in your next presentation. So please click on the link here, join our newsletter, and I will see you in the next video.